to fucking constantly conquer fucking hard
every day.
Every fucking day to stay hard, to stay proud. What's actually important to me is that I lay my head on my pillow and go, am I proud of the day that I live today?
Yes.
I'm proud as fuck, yeah. I helped people. I got my workout. I stuck to my diet. I endured difficult. I endured hard. I fucking made these promises to myself and motherfucker, I kept them.
I disappeared in the middle of the night when I reappeared. Bet the boss looked so proud. Oh, life. Oh, boy. No stripes. Oh, boy. Riding low. Getting 80 round drum, let you know the time. When you see the Maybach, know it's mine. Riding on the two foes, I'm ahead of my time. Watch one of a kind, another one on my mind. Phone bill for a grand, cause you're on my line. In the hood, black funny, only real. They get the touch cash money. I spent about $100 million.
It'll be a great day. I want to take this opportunity to implore you to book the plane ticket, come down, and you hear the conversations of people that share, of the longer term members that show up to everything. That's not done from seeing each other on Zoom or connecting on Discord or whatever it is, you know, online. That is the power of this thing. I'll give you as much game as I have to give. Like, I'll give you everything that I have. But the community of coming together, breaking bread, building relationships, that is what moves the needle. At the end of the day, it's what you know and it's who you know. What you know is incredibly important. What you know, we're going to utilize that in our toolbox every day as we navigate business, as we make decisions, and as we do these things. But I tell you, most of the time when I have to solve a problem, the useful tool that I have out of everything at my disposal is my phone. It's who I know. It's the opportunities that presented themselves. It's by showing up and getting in the room that changed everything for me. It's something I've done very well at. That's how you look at my network. My network is huge. My network is insane. Like, I know a lot of people, a lot of high-level people, et cetera, and it's just by showing up. That did not happen by sitting in my office or my house. That showed up by going to the events, going to the dinners, getting in the room, going to the masterminds, doing this, doing that, connecting with people, showing up, showing up, showing up. You gotta get out there, put the pressure on them. And so, you know, we part of this group is we cultivate that environment for you. So you don't have to go out and do it for yourself and figure it out. We literally go like, hey, there's a yacht. We're going to put you all in the yacht and then we're going to feed you food and you're all going to talk to each other for like 4 hours. Then we're going to take a little break because no one wants to do that for more than 4 hours. And then we're going to get back together and do it again for dinner. And like the stuff that comes out of that, the camaraderie, not to mention, this shit's fucking lonely. Business, entrepreneurship, this is a blood sport. This is not for weak people. Your competition and the market itself is trying to kill you every day. To have allies and to have people to do it with, it just makes it that much more enjoyable, that much more fun. This thing, it causes, I don't know about all of you, but the more successful I got, the more problems I had in relationships that I've legacy people I've had in my life for a long time. You know, jealousy, envy, can I borrow, can I have, must be nice. You don't find that in this group. It's very important that you hang out with your peers. These are your peers. That's why you're in here. And because it was my message that was the flag that drew you in, you guys are automatically have more in common than you even realize because you resonated with content, you resonated with what I was saying, and you came in and said, all right, yeah, I fuck with this. Let me in and let me see who else is here. And so that's my elevator speech of how important it is to get in the room. You know, one of the things about this group and one of the things I say frequently on social media is everyone on here is a real operator. I'm a real operator. I've been sitting in this chair fucking grinding all goddamn day. Connecting with other real operators and brainstorming and having someone to work with from coaching and camaraderie and all that is incredibly important. I might sound egotistical and I might sound prideful, but I'm not. And I tell you what I have because I'm trying to teach you what everyone should have is an insane amount of humility to be able to be a student. Like in my bio, forever student of the game, constantly learning. And so I picked up the phone and started talking with Kent, an experienced business guy, and it was nice to be able to think tank and bounce things off with him and be on the receiving end of this deal. I've come a long way and I end up being the teacher far more than I'm the teachee or the student or the coachee. And so just having that practice, it was great. But then, you know, spent the day with Kent whiteboarding, in the whole time I'm thinking, I'm like, it's reaffirming what I already know, right? It's given me a lot of like, yup, he's agreeing. We're talking through it. I'm like, and it just gives you the confidence to move a little faster and formulate your thoughts, and everything came into vision, although it was already there. A lot of the takeaway was looking at my own organizational chart, leaders, and rebuilding these things or hiring more stuff. And so, you know, what I want to talk to you about my takeaways from that and the season of business that I'm in today is, do you have the right people? Are the people that you have in the right seats on the bus? Do you have the right leaders? What is your organization? If you haven't looked at your organizational chart in a while, it's time to like, maybe it's time to dust it off and look at, what does this thing look like today? And when I grow to these next levels, what should it look like at each one of them? And I start to plan it. Most of us are visionaries. Most of us that end up in here are, you know, we are idea thinkers. And a lot of the people that we need around us are strong integrators. And having people that you can hand these things to and carry out the mission. And so, you know, that's one of the things I got going on right now is, you know, looking at org chart, building and designing org chart for speed and scale and growth. What does it look like today? What does it look like when we're at this next level? What does it look like at the level after that? And doing planning on the growth on that. And then another thing that came up, which was really interesting, was like, we have mission, vision, and values. One of our values should be excellence. Always. Like if you're in business, excellence should be a core value of yours. Like if it's not, then why not? If you have a core value of excellence, where are you compromising your core value and accepting mediocrity? And like when I look at that, I'm like, damn, like I deviated from core values. I made those decisions. It's my responsibility. It's my job as the leader to demand excellence at all times. And so it was a really interesting and fun experiment sitting there with Kent.